Howdy folks, and welcome back once more to Let's Play Legend of Amberland 2. Today, well, we have a lot of stuff that we can poke around in, or at least it feels like we do. You know, boating, training, we can do stuff over here. We do have, Mail has mentioned this multiple times, and I mentioned it, I think, in one of the early episodes, maybe the first episode, I don't remember. We have experimental features, and it adds auto-buffing, I don't know. Yeah, here we go. Auto recast all active party bonus spells at midnight. Features pretty stable and should be moved to regular features too. Alright. I like that they have this separately. One of the experimental rebalances, this changes how dexterity works with enemies, I guess. It affects their attacks and stuff. I don't know. But one of the other things that it does, we're not going to turn it on, but one of the other things that it does is whirling. It buffs it from a 5% chance to hit all monsters to a 25% chance to hit all monsters, which is really good. But I think I'm going to pass on that for the time being. We'll let the experimental stuff stay. Yeah. I suppose we can get some buffs going here. Get Magic Shield and Inspiring Ballad. Feel a faint evil aura. All resistances are -3. Well, that's not very nice. I did not mean to heal everyone, but hey. Alright. I thought we were still fighting. Haha, she's paralyzed. Attack. Thank you. Yeah, so these things aren't too bad. I'm worried about what this does. That probably, like, poisons us. Which is going to be irksome because I have to walk in it. Fucking paralysis. Twice. It's always Brunhilde. Seriously, not funny game. Okay, so what does it do? Oh. Swamp slows you down, skipped one turn. Oh, that's not too bad. I dig it. I like the environmental effects that aren't just you're completely boned. I was recasting buffs repeatedly again. Darkwood Forest -6 to buffs. I wish I could get rid of this. Walking a double eye. Oh, she's petrified. That is definitely less than bueno. These guys don't worry me over much, but petrification, that is a whole beast that I don't think I'm ready to handle right now. I don't think I have a cure for that either. Okay, is there? There is. Oof. There goes basically all the money that we just earned. All right. Do I have food? I have one. I want to go over there to that boat. Because I think we can maybe afford that, and I think we just recast all of our buffs. Which, while nice, I think this is one of the reasons that I didn't want to turn it on, is because when we're overland traveling, like, we're going to be just wasting all of our mana as I'm wandering from area to area. So I think we'll leave the auto buffing off for the time being. Okay, nobody's ready to level. Chunk is near. The 13th level characters, the elves, are a ways off. What did I want to do? I wanted to do something here, but it wasn't here. I want to see, how much was it to get that boat? I think it was 800. Basic navigation, yes, all right. Let's go beat the shit out of some goblins and take a boat. I remember you little farts were over here. It's interesting that we fought goblins in the very beginning, but by the time you would come over here, you would have fought things much, much stronger. So, what I wonder is if they're baiting us into something. or if this is just where we were intended to come all along and I just skipped the entire newbie zone because I'm a stupid, stupid boy. It is nice, I will say, beating the crap out of something instead of constantly having to really watch my ass. So what do we have here? Swamp cave. All right, good talk. Quick save. What do we got? It's gonna be, oh, snacks. All right. We've killed many a snack in our day. You're magic fisting, aren't you, Sonroll? I just saw Sonroll hit this thing for 160. Now you're casting lightning bolt. Yeah, I was gonna say, magic fist doesn't hit that hard. Hey. To his credit, Swell is just taking the envenomation like a champ there. I'm not depoisoning him, it doesn't do that much damage. Come on guys, there we go. Hello friends. It is very polite that the enemies just kind of hang out and wait. I do kind of enjoy that. Fireball, fireball. Those are the only fireballs we're going to be casting in this fight. I don't think more will be necessary. There we go. One thing that I do wish this did, and it's something that I would have liked in the previous game even, is because we're constantly opening this to cast spells because I don't want to auto-cast certain spells. I would love it if caster types, there were perhaps a mini hotbar here at, say, the bottom of the screen, or, you know, kind of overlap it down here that could have maybe, you know, four or five spells on it that you could just quick hotkey for casters. So that, like for Gold Leaf, I could just have, you know, her auto attack just being attack. And then if I hit one, it heals. If I hit two, it's mass heal, that kind of thing. Just to kind of save having to constantly open this menu and scroll around in it and stuff. I don't know. Grand Blade of Courage. All right. 105 damage, fear resistance, 9 weight. Well, I mean, that's going to be an update for Brunhilde, a tiny one, but we'll buff the damage nonetheless. Hello, guys. I'm going to charge you. Nail you both. You do not have to do anything. You don't have to do anything. Fireball. Fireball. Because, yeah, then in actual trash fights, I could even have the back row, their default thing, just be attack. Although, with as cheap as Magic Arrow is, I don't think there's really any reason not to have Magic Arrow just be the auto cast for your mages. All right, let's get Inspiring Ballad. Let's get Magic Shield. Melee. Attack. Spell. Royal Small Shield, you say? Plus one armor, paralysis, and protection. Yeah, I was gonna say, yeah, we already have protection though. But that is, again, an upgrade for Brunhilde. Making out like a bandit in here. I'm okay with it though, because she's been kind of getting the short end of the stick for the entire playthrough up to this point with regards to gear upgrades. You can heal Swell. Ooh, okay, 3 of them. I was not expecting that. There's the poison. Heal. Fireball. Probably gonna get a second round of fireballs here, too. You don't need to heal, just murder. Just one. And a power fist. Oh, they just keep coming. But if it's just one, that's not too bad. very manageable. That poison is cantankerous. Magic armor. What even is this? Sorcery and invisibility. Invisibility is so good. Why does it gotta be so heavy though? Damn it. Put it on swell. But I recall vitality being pretty solid. 5% less damage. I don't know how much that's really helping him. Whereas this is just a fucking flat 30% mischance. Damn. It's got good resistances on it too. I think I'm gonna keep him with the vitality. Spell's pretty impervious. Let's see, how are we looking? Wow, is that everything? No secrets? Just zip through the halls here one more time. Because I was not at all paying attention. Where did you even come from, sir? Thought I'd cleared this place out. Alright. That was pretty reasonable. Wasn't bad at all. Swamp, you can't do nothing. You're not the boss of me. You can slow me down, but you can never stop me. We shall advance forthwith. We gotta mow the map. Just make sure we've gotten everything here. Tax collectors are cowards. Can you believe that none visited me last year? I had to go to the castle myself to pay taxes. They even tried to say I have some exemption just so they did not need to visit me. Went straight to the chancellor and demanded to have this cleared up. I'm a law-abiding peasant. I will pay taxes to my liege, even if his incompetent officials claim otherwise. Poor king. Uldric, you need to be taken out into the streets and beaten. You get out of taxes, you get out of taxes, bro. Okay, let's go to the boat. Alright, man, teach me. Bam. Proof of voyages, and now we have access to this, which, I mean, I suppose is just a fast way to go back and forth here, but otherwise seems pretty well pointless. Neat. Let's go to town. We'll have a nappy. Training, anybody? Yes, actually. Basically, everybody that wasn't already level 14 has deemed for it. Ooh, chain lightning! Cleansing of mind. Oh, I'm excited. And then restoration on Devon will be nice. So next level is going to be a big one. That's, they're a ways away, though. They need about 3 times what the rest of the party does at current time. Well, at least the humans. You guys, is there a pawn shop here? Is it down here? Yes, okay, I wanna vendor some garbage here. Like, realistically, I'm gonna hold on to the helm of invisibility, but the rest of this stuff I don't think I'm gonna use. I love that we can sell this glowing violet key used in Alizar's caves, but I don't think it takes up any inventory space. Is there even limited inventory space? I don't think there is. I'm not selling it. Displacement. Oh, this is like invisibility, but better. They just miss. I like it. Also expensive. +4 strength, +2 dex. There's some good gear here. Roll twice for damage. I gotta say, I really like these purple enchantments on gear. They seem very meaningfully powerful. And I like that. Because you've got your regular stuff where it's just your, you know, plus X resistances, plus Y to ability scores. The kind of, I guess you could say, vanilla things that every RPG has. And then you've got the really powerful enchantments. And I like that. It's cool, and it might make you use gear that you otherwise wouldn't because it doesn't have, you know, the perfect stats on it or whatnot. But hey, this gives me a 1/3% mischance on everything, and that's pretty good. Alright, new island. The island hopping in this honestly reminds me of King's Bounty. Like the original King's Bounty. The good King's Bounty. Like, trigger some fans of Armored Princess and all of those with that. I'm not a huge fan of the new King's Bounties. They feel different to me, and I don't know how else to explain it. No, I'm talking like the old DOS one. Where you'd just kind of sail around the map, hopping to different islands, murdering what you can, and otherwise just hiding and praying you don't get eaten by dragons. Welcome, travelers. I suspect you wish to perish in the great desert, as many before you. I used to try to talk people out of entering this zone infested with deadly scorpions, but no one listened, so I stopped. What I could have offered would be the last meal, but I'm afraid the last visitors ate everything. What a dick. Oh, no. We'll fight ogres. That skeleton's probably like level 30 or something. And we are just wimpy little babby adventurers yet. You know, there's an alternative route. You don't need to cross the Great Desert to reach Embershore. Why I know you want to go there? Well, there's nothing else worth traveling to on this whole archipelago. Anyway, you can use the southern caves to reach town. It's much safer. Oh, man. What do you guys want to bet this is going to be a cave full of yet more ogres? We haven't fought enough ogres. I got a magical ogre slaying knife. It's got a +3 against ogres. I don't think it was a +3, was it? It's a +5? It's been so long since I've watched the Dead Ale Wives. Yeah, let's heal. I mean, we're kicking the shit out of these things, which is nice. I remember the first ogres that we fought, one of them was not nothing, and now we're just kind of butchering them in numbers. And this is my favorite part of RPGs. I remember when those things were scary and now I'm making them look like assholes phase of the game. Where you get to kind of stomp on things that previously beat the crap out of you. It's always nice. Okay, so since this is supposedly the safe way over here, that leads me to believe those scorpions are shit kickers. There used to be a dwarven settlement here many, many years ago, but they found better ore deposits on the western island, so they relocated. I did not. Anyway, there are three caves connected to each other. If you go through those, you'll reach the town. Thanks, Cabaldur. I can't tell. Is that... That looks like a star field out there, like a field of stars. And that is totally World of Zine. I wonder if we're going to be jumping to little islands out in space to reset satellites later on. Okay, let's see. Level 25. Okay. Note to self, scorpions are a no-go. Okay. And this little mountain trek already reminds me of... What is it, hour 21? This reminds me of Death Mountain in... God, what is it? The second Zelda game on the NES, Link's Adventure. Where you gotta bop through all the caves to figure out how to get to the last temple. Magic Shield and Inspiring Ballad. I shouldn't have cast those now, I should have waited, which I told myself I was going to do before I picked that fight, and then I picked the fight and started going on about old Zelda games and my brains leaked out my ears. However, it looks like these are fairly short caves as it is. These are the AoE guys, yeah. Oh, this... This could get dangerous. these things will stack, which they do. Okay. We'll use real magic and kill them quickly. Wasting all of our mana, but whatever. We do have plenty of food. Our buffs just wore off. I want to fireball these guys. Yes. Who needs mana? We have Power Fist. What? It's what plants crave. Wait, no. Wrong. 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 I don't think we need to heal. Famous last words. Yeah, this one was a little bit more grueling than I was expecting. Alright. Cure poison. We're gonna pull back. You're gonna have a nap. Getting our spell points back. And we're just gonna lightning bolt these things. 252, good roll. My hope is that chain lightning is that level of damage, but it hits everything. That would be great. Because with the whole re-rolling damage thing that they've got on their gear, like, our rolls with lightning are real good. Okay, last chunk here, so we'll get buffs going. Do I want to heal? Yeah, okay. We can afford to heal. What in the ever-loving god? It's me when I wake up in the morning. Cave troll. All right, strike, melee. 41, not too crazy. Even sounds like me. Old cave troll, here we go. Now we found ghost. Tired old ghost, playing video games until the, oh, AoE, that's, so are you just an AoE attacker then? Is that your, no, you do single target. Pretty good damage too. My god, I was hoping there was maybe only a couple of these guys in here, but now it looks like we're fighting. It's only level 12. These things are beefy lads. Macro's running out of mana. You do not want to see that happening. Hello, play song. Focus. Okay. Hey, this one's as good as dead, so I'm not going to waste spells on it. Swell will probably kill it, yeah. Oh my god, and there are more yet behind. This could go pear-shaped. If I'm not careful. Uh-oh. They're just staggering in. Oh, this is... I think this is manageable. But this is not nice. In that case, fireball. Sunroll has extra mana because he didn't have to buff. There's one. We might as well heal. We don't need two. Swap over to magic arrows. You have another lightning bolt? You do. These are worth a lot of experience. I think I saw that thing was worth 1,200. Nap. I should have just waited a couple. Well, it doesn't matter. We'd be rebuffing anyways. Our buffs are gonna, fall off here. That's okay. Did I see another one down there? You guys not moving? Right, you ain't moving. You aren't moving. I think I saw the XP value. I think I saw these things are worth like 1200 experience points each. That's really freaking good. Assuming I was, oh, it might have been, oh no, it would have been 1200 for that huge group of them we killed. Okay, so 1200 for four, I think. So they're about 300 experience apiece. That's a little bit more in the realm of what I was expecting. Yeah, 300 a pop. Still not bad. How are we actually looking? Oh yeah, people are ready to level. Oh yes. Oh yes, blessed chain lightning. Oh, come on, stack up. I'm gonna fight y'all. I'm gonna fight you in a group so that I can AoE you. No fire susceptibility, sadly. They are thick lads, I have to give them that. Fireball, and then lightning bolt. Kill this guy. Work our way through what's left of them here with just some magic arrows. Okay. We're doing okay. I'm pretty confident. Unless there's some mega troll down here, which it wouldn't surprise me if there were. But I think we'll be okay. Okay, well, my mind is on it. Inspiring Ballad, Magic Shield. So yeah, with all of our buffs going, Swell can tank hits from these dudes. I wouldn't say effortlessly, but without much issue. The other melees have a bit more trouble with it. But Swell has so much health and so much armor. How much health does he have comparatively? Not as much more than these guys as I thought, and Brunhilde's actually like 40 hit points away from him. Oh no, it's more of the old stogies. Hey buddy. Play song for mana, and I'm gonna have these guys open with some lightning. Is that another one? No. Hello, basic cave troll. Not enough mana? The hell you say? Ooh! Brunhilde cutting it close. I wonder. That might have been her heroism proccing and saving her ass from getting one shot by this thing. Okay, old troll's down there. Ah! Helm of Clarity, Ring of Iron Will. Complete fucking luck that I even noticed that. Good to know that they don't put all secrets at the end of the obvious hallways, though. God damn it. Who knows what I've missed? So what do we have here? Ring of Iron Will. Willpower and fear resistance. I'm probably going to hold on to this even if I don't use it, purely for the fear resist effect on it. And the Helm of Clarity. It's just confusion and fear. Solid maybe on that one. I like the ring because rings don't take up any encumbrance, which is kind of nice. All right, we're actually going to go back. I want to go level and get chain lightning. And every little bit helps, and I think that'll probably be as reasonable a place as I need to call it an episode. It's kind of irksome having to schlep our ways all the way back. But that's what we get for not having unlocked the fast travel yet. Let's see, nearest town is right down here. Wait, that's not a town. Shit. Damn it! Town's up here. There it is. Give me my levels. Chain lightning. I'm curious what cleansing mind is. Got level 16 on the humans. Damn. Give him some mana. Give him some knowledge. Give him some give him some strength. Chunk only cares about might. Might makes right. Swell, toughness, Brunhilde, strength. Devon, you're terrible. Have some willpower. Sunral, also mana. All right, so let's see what these new spells do. Chain Lightning. All right, so yeah, Chain Lightning is lightning, but for everybody, and substantially less damage. For the mana cost, oof. Realistically, probably won't be casting that over Fireball. And Cleansing Mind is Mesmerized and Confusion Cleansing. All right. Nice. Well, I think on that note, I'm going to go ahead and call it an episode here. So, as usual, folks, thank you for watching. Hope you all had a good time. And I will see you all next time where an adventure continues. Until then. Hey, you made it to the end. Nice. If you had a good time, check out one of these other series, see if you like them. Drop a like, comment, or subscribe if you'd like to support the channel, via the machine and all that. As always, thanks for watching.